No, I don't waste no time.
What's going on, guys, and welcome back to a new video. For those of you that are new to the channel, my name is Joshua Daniel George, a social media marketing online coach. I have my own social media marketing agency called Brandpreneur, and I also have my own education business where I teach you guys on how to do the same. So how to start your own social media marketing agency, how to get your first client, how to automate it, scale it, so that you too can live life on your own terms. And in this video, I want to be talking about Facebook's conversion window. Why? Well, first of all, it took me a while to figure out where it actually was, how you can utilize it, and how it basically, you know, optimizes your Facebook campaigns. And now, because I have my own digital products, we have clients that have their own info products, etc. as well, you know, I basically did a little bit more digging into what the conversion window actually is, and I just thought I'd share the knowledge with you guys. And basically, the Facebook conversion window is a window which people that view your ad and click on it and become a paying customer, basically the size of the window in which Facebook uses that to convert or optimize the conversions and your conversion campaigns. And for those of you that still find that a little bit unclear, basically what the way you need to see it is, let's say you have it at the default, which is a 7-day click, 1-day view, and someone converts within, like I said, 7 days or within 1 day of viewing your advertisement, then Facebook will basically, you know, take that within the optimization phase, which means that, by the way, guys, quick side note, that does not mean that Facebook, if you fall outside of that, that does not mean that Facebook will not basically claim that purchase has come through Facebook. So for example, you've got the 7-day click, 1-day view set up, and within 8 days of clicking on the advertisement, you get a conversion. Facebook will, you will still see that conversion within the business manager, but Facebook will not use that when optimizing the campaigns. So the more data you have within your campaigns, the more Facebook can optimize, which makes sense. You know, the more data that Facebook has, you know, the more it can look for more of those conversions that you're optimizing for. So let's say we're optimizing for purchase, and you know, you're getting X amount of purchases. Facebook will learn about what kind of people will convert for your offer, and obviously the more data Facebook has, the more they can find more people like the people that have converted. However, if they fall outside of that period that you have as your conversion window, Facebook will still register it as a conversion, but not take it within that optimization process. So let's say John from the UK purchases within 8 days of clicking on his advertisement, then yes, you will still see John's purchase in your business manager, but John will fall outside of that conversion window, which means that Facebook will not find more Johns for you. And this is very interesting to know and very interesting to play around with, because let's say, for example, you have a email campaign alongside your Facebook ads campaign. You can basically mix and match and see basically what the conversion window needs to be for you to know that Facebook is optimized to the best of its abilities, and that, you know, your email campaign is not interfering with the conversions on Facebook. So let's say you get 20 conversions, 20 purchases, and you know, you want to know specifically, okay, is it coming from the advertisements or is it coming from the emails? And you know, how is Facebook optimizing for that? And basically by playing around with that conversion window, you know, you can optimize and make sure that Facebook's ads are getting optimized as much as they possibly can. So by default, I don't mess around with this too much. I keep it to the, you know, the default settings, which, like I said, is the 7-day view, 1-day click. But let's say, for example, you get more than 50 conversions a day, then you can, for example, change that to, for example, a 1-day click, because you've got enough data to be more specific. And obviously, you know, the less data you have, so if you've got less than 50 conversions a day for the basically the element that you're optimizing for, add to cards, purchase, whatever, then I would just stick to the default. And again, guys, like, this is something that I'm looking into myself. You know, I'm basically learning as I go along, but I just thought I'd share my knowledge, which I've basically, you know, gained so far about what to do. Like I said, so more than 50 conversions, you can test out the 1-day click. Less than 50 conversions, just stick to the default. And I'll probably do an update video on this, you know, soon, basically with more knowledge when I've done a little bit more testing. So Hope you got something out of this video. Like the video if you did. Leave a comment down below if you have any more Facebook specific questions. For those of you that aren't not yet in the Facebook community, I have a Facebook group called Lifestyle Design Community where I basically answer all your questions. I am more active than ever nowadays. There's a free mini social media marketing course in there as well as a free copy of my Lifestyle Design Playbook. So if you have not requested access to that Facebook just yet, make sure you do. For those that are serious about starting their own social media marketing agency and want my personal help in doing so, like I said, I also have my own coaching business where I basically take you guys on as a client and build out your agency from the inside out. Again, we'll all be linked in the description box down below. Like this video if you got something out of it, subscribe to the channel for more, and I'll see you guys in the next video.